The old stereotype of the pageant contestant is being overturned by a new generation of accomplished women who just happen to also be drop-dead gorgeous. One of these is mechanical engineer Avania Reddy, who shared some of her ideas, dreams, and ambitions with Karusha.
The KwaZulu-Natal coastline is a classic backdrop for fashion photography. And as a regional finalist in the Miss SA pageant, Avania Reddy is a photographer's dream model.
Those are absolutely stunning. I love them.
Hello, Avania. So nice to meet you. I can see I'm catching you in something.
Just had a shoot with you, Veer. Thank you so much. It's such a good one. We caught the beautiful morning sun. Thanks,
you,
Veer.
I'll see you guys later.
Take care.
Cheers. So, Avania, what are we doing here?
I'm a model part-time, so I'm busy building my portfolio. I've done fashion shoots, I've done the magazine-type vibe, and I do like to dabble in photography myself, so I wanted to learn from him how to capture the perfect natural light.
So you're only a model part-time?
My 8 to 6 is product management. So I've come from an engineering background, I have an engineering degree, and I found myself in the very corporate world and product space, which I'm enjoying. It's beautiful, it's stimulating.
So if you aren't doing a photo shoot on the beach, how would you be starting your morning?
Very much a coastal girl. I love being on the beach, especially in the mornings with my two babies, Gatsby and Lana. And if you'd like to, you could please join me.
Great. So what do you love the most about Durban?
The ocean, the beach, of course. We're blessed with one of the best climates in the world. And the morning sun and this view, I mean, this is home.
Oh, there they are now.
There are the two babies. Hello, Lana. Hello, Gatsby. They've just had a morning walk on the beach.
Oh, they're so sweet.
And this is my sister, Talia, and my brother, Nikhil.
Hi, guys. Have you always loved animals?
Yes, always. It comes from being deeply spiritual. My family's always been one to go on and on about it's not just human beings that have souls, and I think that's where my love for animals stems.
That's beautiful.
So it's been such a long morning for me. I have an avid love for a good cup of coffee. I actually want to own a coffee shop of my own one day. And one of my favorite spots is just around the corner.
So wait, you want to own a coffee shop?
Yes, so entrepreneurship skills is something I'm trying to build as well, on top of photography, on top of modeling. And I love beautiful spaces, especially out in the open, and I love coffee. Please join me.
Well, that sounds absolutely wonderful. I'd love to hear all about it. Let's go. Tell me about this coffee shop idea.
I absolutely love coffee. It is my go-to in the mornings, and with travel, I've tasted beautiful European coffee, and no two coffees taste the same. And marrying my kind of love for beautiful spaces and lighting and photography, I want to capture my love for coffee and bring it to life through a coffee shop.
And how does that tie in with your engineering background?
Engineering and my degree taught me how to think. Being able to look at a problem, to look at a scenario, break it down, understand it, and build it up the way you want to, that for me is the most powerful tool. And I use it everywhere. I use it in my personal life. I use it at work. So it's given me a lot of confidence, really.
Who or what would you say has been your biggest influence in life so far?
My mum, she is one of the strongest women I've ever met. Most amount of respect for her. And then keeping it within the family, my grandfather. He was a very intelligent, outspoken man. He always made me feel at a very young age that I could do anything.
How do you manage to constantly pursue new things and try new things whilst maintaining everything else in your life?
At the root of it all, it's passion. So whether it's modeling or whether it's my corporate life, it all stems from a place of pure enjoyment. I enjoy pushing myself mentally. I enjoy feeling like I have purpose. I enjoy sitting in a room full of men, and I'm the only single lone female voice, and I actually bring something to the table.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
I am currently chasing senior management within the corporate world, so I'm not ready to give that up just yet. And of course, definitely have my own business.
If there was a message that you could say you live your life by it, what would it be?
Self-confidence is absolute key, and if you do not believe in your core that you can do something, you cannot expect anybody else to believe in you either. At some point, you can find yourself in a rut, and you've got to be able to find that inner strength to pull yourself out of it.
What a beautiful message. Thank you so much for spending time with me today. I've really enjoyed it.